let's have this. Okay, so if they go to check on where he would be, and she'd probably be following them just to show them where it is. And then while they're in there checking on him, while she's behind them, she just, to their knowledge, just sort of vanishes. There's no trace of her. She's just gone while they're talking to the guy in the house.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah. So she vanishes.
She's still unaware that her husband's missing or whoever's missing?
Well, she was unaware. She thought her husband was missing, but she's just stupid.
Okay.
And then, while Jund and Snake are there to check on the place, and they find the husband, and he's just sitting there eating mac and cheese.
Alright. They
turn
around, she's missing?
Yes, because she's...
And then we turn back to the husband, it's like, my wife's been dead for 8 years. What?
Yes!
Oh, roll investigation, please. You guys want some mac and cheese?
That would be such a good... Holy shit!
Oh,
but who was phone?
That's why it's a fax machine, because she's...
Oh my god.
She's from the past!
Dude, we call this episode Ghost in the Machine? And then, like, the ending is that the fax machine was haunted all along. And then it's gonna lead to the next case where it's like someone who got murdered is sending a fax.
Don't know.
And you gotta go find out who murdered them.
Oh, who did it? No. Dude, I actually really like that. It's like
Ghost Rider.
It's chill. It's not terribly long. It's that works, man. Oh, okay, we're doing that. Fuck yeah.
All right.
Hell yeah. This is like, how many revisions has this story gone through?
This is number 4. We're 0.4. We haven't even got a finished product.
Whew. Okay. And you do get used to it. Wait, okay, so if this is the case, she faxed them. Maybe we got to get rid of the local police force thing idea?
Not I was just also thinking about filler.
Time. Oh, gotcha.
But if you want to, that's cool.
If we're going with that route, she contacted them directly. If she contacted the local police, they would have probably already checked that suite, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, totally.
Yeah, so let's go with that route then. Let's see, celebrity detective visit. Okay. Go to the town. Okay. Town and to the address. On the facts that was listed and stuff. I don't know how the fuck to say what else there. Okay. So. Oh, I gotta refix this part. Nice and thick. She says her husband gone missing. The last time she saw him, he was in the in-law suite and hasn't seen him since. So, upon investigating the mother-in-law suite, find the man sitting there in his boxers eating mac and cheese, watching. Let's give it a good fantasy show that would be relevant and like pay homage to a current show. Like maybe Bone of Games or something like that.
Bone of Games. That's definitely got to be like the porno version, right?
Yeah, of course.
Actually, Game of Bones. Not even Game of Bones. Nope, it was Bone Games. Oh, fuck. Alright, so. Me and Mac and Cheese watching Game of Bones. No, that's too close. Let's keep a Bone of Games. Let's keep Bone
and
of Games.
And the main character says his famous catch line, Bazooper. Bazooper.
So they're watching Bone of Games as the catchphrase Bazooper is heard on the TV.
That's the only detail we give of that. Yeah, that part's done.
Nothing else. The man questions what the fuck is up, and the and tells them his wife has been dead for 8 years.
Bum bum bum.
The wife is now gone, and it's spooky, and if the players didn't get the fucking hint, we'll send in a dove with a note that says the fax machine is haunted. Or something like that. At that point. Maybe he'll even say, like the guy could say, sounds like a fax machine's haunted.
But they're gonna go to the house, right? And they're gonna actually see this woman lady, right?
Yeah, they'll see her.
And she's gonna lead her back to the suite.
Yeah.
They open the door. There he is.
And then she's just not there. Yeah.
Yeah. And then they turn around. She's gone.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. So we gotta find a way to make sure they get the idea that it's haunted. How would we instill that in their head?
Maybe when they're at the police station and they're checking out stuff, there's like paranormal activity fucking scanner. Oh wait, it's modern times. I keep thinking of like sci-fi and shit.
Yeah, right. It's kind of hard.
Okay. Well, it's fantasy, so maybe they got to get like maybe some kind of magical relic that could do something with ghosts. Maybe no. Must be a necromancer in the area, putting ghosts in the machine.
Oh my god. Wait. How? Okay, do you think...
Thinking.
We need the fantasy element?
Now it's just normal detectives and we'll just put paranormal stuff in there?
Yeah.
Alright, Revision 5, let's go.
It's kind of like X-Files, you know?
Alright, yeah, we X-Files now.
We X-Files. I like X-Files. X-Files is the shit.
X-Files, alright. They got some stinker, like, filler, though.
They do. That's true.
But otherwise, it's pretty fucking good.
Yeah, fuck it. We'll make them Scully and Mulder.
And we can add the smoking man, and then people can Pepe smoke all they want.
It's true.
Chat was the smoking man.
All the time. Alright, that's cool. So have this part here.
Scully, you won't believe this. She never fucking did. Scully, you were abducted. I don't believe it.
Yeah, she was very against the belief of it. Okay. So honestly, I think that's a pretty good skeleton, at least. We even got Bazooper in there.
Bazooper.
Bazooper.
Canned laughter. Bass boosted canned laughter.
Jesus.
Okay. Played on Parsec so they hear it too.
Yes, absolutely. Okay, so. Oh, you know, that could be kind of cool. We can make like a soundboard of the special things.
Yeah.
I don't know how to make a soundboard.
What we've always done was rig it where we just have like a playlist on like VLC or whatever you use, and then you just, you know, double click it when you need it and then hit stop.
Oh, I was just gonna be like,
you hear the sound of the catchphrase, and then I press Bazooper. A button, and it plays Bazooper, and that's just it, you know?
Yeah.
Is that what you mean?
Kinda. I mean, that sounds fancy. I don't know how to do that.
But yeah, I need to figure out how to do that. What if detectives have to solve an arcing story of why the genre of that world keeps changing on a whim?
They keep fucking falling into new dimensions, and they don't even know it.
Wow.
Just like the Mandela effect.
Whoa.
Bernstein Bears.
Every night they go to bed, it wakes up and it's another genre. And they're the only ones who notice any different.
Oh my god. Can't wait for the Groundhog's Day episode.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Okay. What else do we need now? I feel like we got everything covered.
How did they figure out it's haunted? How did they figure it out?
The guy could mention it. Like,
his wife said,
casually mentioned, you know.
Maybe your fax machine's haunted.
Yeah, because he doesn't give a fuck. Like, he's past caring. He doesn't give a fuck.
Why doesn't he live in the house anymore?
I guess we need a reason for that, huh?
Why?
Maybe.
Why are you in your boxers?
Well, it's comfortable. He's just chilling. Maybe the house is for sale? And he's living in the back on the...
He's squatting in his own house?
Yeah, he's squatting, yeah.
And they have to, like, keep it pristine for, like, show and tell or whatever it's called, open house?
Yeah. And there's a for sale sign out front, and then if they ask her about
it... Oh, that'd be even more suspicious.
Yeah, but if they ask her about it, she'll just be like, oh, that's been there forever, nobody wants this place. Or something like that, you know?
Oh, man, what if they get the wrong mistake? They think the house is haunted. And then they want to stay there for the night.
Nothing happens.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, pretty much. But I mean, if they do stay there, maybe, like, while they're there, they could, like, hear phantom sounds of fax machines or something.
Hear the dial-up sounds?
Yeah. And then I'm just waiting until Snake understands it finally. And then I want to hear him just say, the fax machine. Because he'll just be so excited.
Oh my god.
Wow. This is great. The house right. is... This is we have a good plot here. Okay.
Yeah.
So, wife is now gone. It's spooky. And if players didn't get... it's spooky. And... The guy casually mentions, hey, your fax machine might be haunted. I don't know. Something like that. Seriously, though, don't they need to fight stuff? I personally find fighting to be the least fun part of D&D.
Yep.
So, we just kind of say, fuck that. Like... Anytime fighting happens, I just kind of zone out. This is pretty much just interactive storytelling.
While you wait like 15 minutes for your turn to show up.
Yeah.
And then your turn has to change because someone fucked it up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't use D&D, use another system.
Let's just call Cthulhu. We can learn that in a night.
Can we? Is it hard?
I'm not learning that.
Oh, so it is hard.
I mean, we can just use a D&D system.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with using a D&D system as long as you just don't do the combat parts. I mean...
Plus, they have guns.
Yeah.
They have guns.
They do have guns. Roll to shoot. Did you get them? Almost.
Probably.
I don't know. How? I guess we gotta do think about what kind of thing we would do there, huh?
I don't know. I just made you guys roll a d20, and if it was, like, adequate, I didn't even have a DC or anything. I'd just be like, yeah, it's pretty fucking good. Yeah, you got that alien.
Yeah. I don't see the problem with that.
I like fun.
Yeah. Rules. I do too. I'm not a stickler for the rules as long as everyone's having a fun time. It's not like we're doing competitive D&D or anything.
Right.
So. Yeah. Well. You mentioned, hey, you're fixing these Honda. Okay, cool. That happened. Oh. Wait, there's no Gorgon anymore. That's right.
Nah, it's from, like, next episode or some shit.
Yeah, this initial one's super...
Legendary
super easy.
Fax machine. This campaign will be done in 15 minutes.
Yeah. Okay,
so... It took us an hour, almost 2 hours to write.
If the players go back to the office on...
Should there be a new fax waiting for
yeah,
them?
Yeah.
Face down.
Gotta
turn it over.
Waiting for them. Face down, and if they turn it over,
it says this page intentionally left blank. Ba, ba, ba!
Printer alignment cheat.
Yep. Gotta check those jets, you know what I'm saying? Those ink jets.
Very important. Let's see here. It says... To be continued.
Oh, shit. And then we give away a shirt.
Holy shit, that's real fucking old school.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. I could say that. Are we still in space? No, that's an old revision. Because... We want it to be lighthearted still.
Yeah.
So we don't need to get all serious.
Now we need to add content.
Yeah, we need actual content. But what did it actually say? Did we ever decide?
No.
Oh. Please rate and click the bell.
It's a photocopy of someone's butt. My God.
Oh, it's a photocopy of their butts, but they have no memory of doing it.
Oh, my God. And they can, like, clarify it because there's a tattoo on a butt. And he's all like, wait, I never got a tattoo. And then he has a tattoo on his ass.
Oh, my God.
And it'll lead them to their next case.
It's a photocopy of... Should we just pick gender or snake, Zass?
Roll a dice, dude.
Of one of the players' asses, and they just know it's their ass, and they...
I know this ass, it's mine.
See a tattoo on the ass, and are like, what?
And it's an arrow.
If they
and
look.
Then it's pointing at the other guy's ass. And then he pulls down his pants and he says, I'm a stupid.
If they look at their ass, they see the tattoo. And then the credits happen. To be continued. Alright, what kind of tattoo do we want?
Oh, man.
Maybe the tattoo could be like, Oh, can we make a QR code? Is that a thing we can do? I don't know
I'm
how to
sure
make
it's
them.
Possible. I think you can do like images to QR codes, so when people scan it, it pops up with an image. I think some websites do that.
Yeah, so then we'll and give then them you... a QR code to use.
And then it'll just be a JoJo's to be continued. My God, so deep.
We can either do, like, that, or, like, I guess if they're feeling it, like, a hint to the next one or something, you know what I mean?
Yeah, of course.
Shit. I don't know. I think that JoJo's to be continued would be better. We can just do that one.
I don't think so.
No?
No.
Oh, shit.
I don't know.
Who knows? Okay, so now we need actual content. How do we make content? Is this all going to be like... How are we doing this?
Alright, so they got to like get around, right? They got to drive somewhere. You said there was a caddy?
Oh, yeah, I figured just give him a caddy, yeah.
Alright.
Actually, that was probably one of the other revisions. I think it was. I gotta sneeze.
Bless you.
Hey. Where was that? Caddy was removed. We can give them a caddy anyway, though.
Alright.
Two sloppy detectives who share a caddy. Okay, are on the job. All
right. We need some kind of flying nuisance that's gonna attack the car, and they gotta like one drives and one shoots. That's how you add content, dude.
Oh shit! Genius.
Oh, yeah, it's gonna be bats. It's from bats.
Oh no, it's bat country. Fuck.
And you cue the music, and then they just start rolling.
Yeah, that works.
And if they fail, they wreck and die, and that's the end of that story.
Okay, on the way to the woman's house, bunch of bats are flying around everywhere. And the intro sequence plays.
Hell yeah. Hit the theme music, dude.
Potatoes.
Sloppy bros.
Ooh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. And then they get to the house. Awesome.
Hell yeah, dude.
There we go.
They gotta make them roll to put on their sunshades and look cool, else they look like dorks.
Oh, God. Okay. What are we playing this in? Are we gonna be using, like, Roll 20 or, like...
Let's use tabletop.
Okay.
Because easy peasy, and you can just draw a box. Like I used to. Easy.
Much, much easier that way. Okay. I think we're good then. We have a beginning, middle, and end.
Yeah.
It's super lighthearted and it's pretty minimal. They can make it longer if they want to by fucking around. We can just freestyle stuff.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, that's what I always do.
I want to go on the house, I want to check the freezer. Yeah, oh, shit. Is that a hot pocket?
Yeah, in the freezer, you see one hot pocket and two hot dogs.
What do you choose?
Speaking of food, I've had food ready for, like, a while. I'll be right back.
That shit's gonna be cold.
I know, it sucks. Talk to the people.
What's up? What's up, chat? Now I want hot dogs? Man. I don't know if Cry remembers this, but he called me once and I missed it. And he left me a voicemail that said, I'm making hot dogs. That was all it was. I was entirely confused. Russ, cool guy. Oh man, thanks. Right. You guys see my new dummy emote? You can be a security officer now. Yep, there goes Angry Knees. He's harm batoning that clown. Russell loser, that's typical sushi. Was that Apple that made an animation for that? I don't know if he did or not. I didn't know there was an animation for that. It was during Mount Your Friends. Oh, dude, Expo Mike, if I had like trivia points to give out, there you go. I can only believe you because I don't remember. Oh, thanks, Nurkral. Thank you. I love me too. Yo, NicoHime1314. Thank you for the 14 months in a row. Continue patronage to this channel. Please enjoy your emotes. Have you any popsicles? I don't have any popsicles. I haven't had popsicles in my house for, like, forever. I've only had, like, the icicles. The ones, like, colored flavored water. You freeze it, and it's like, yeah, that's good enough, I guess. Would you mind slapping me with an explanation of the plan? This is it. You're looking at it. What's up, Gippy Peanut? What's up, Dunk? Freeze Pop? Yeah, that sounds about right. I don't need them, though. Not for me. I have a freezer full of the pops. What's your favorite flavor? Mine's red. I feel when Russ talks is more than Cry ever does. I don't think that's true at all. What if in the campaign for solving cases they get picorettes? Oh shit. We should have picorettes. I want Russ to impreg me. I'm 43-year-old 400 daughter. Oh, you want me to impregnate your daughter? I get you. I'm good. I have a bunch of piece of cakes from Costco's. Costco's? I don't know. When I read cake, I want cheesecake now. That's what that made me do. Somebody, like, instead of giving bits, send me cheesecake. When is Babyface going to be an emote? Never, because I don't own the copyrights to that face. That face belongs to a young boy who wants to be a young Smooth McGroove, and he's doing a great job. My thick boy, I'm pretty fucking thick. I like thick because it's the new word for fat. Yeah, I'm a fat boy. When's the next session of EO Hell? Oh man, I wanted to sign up for the next bounty, but then I said, and then it went away. I didn't say anything, it just went away. You go to Cheesecake Factory as a family? Maybe. If you start being annoying, I'm gonna turn this car around. We're not getting any cheesecake. That'll make me more mad than you, probably. Get player hint coins? Oh man, perfect. What's my fave hentai? I like it when they have the bouncy, bouncy titties. That's with D's, not T. Ditties. Do you guys give the bounty for it? I think so. I don't remember, so I can't look it up. What kind of cheesecake? Dude, I like chocolate. I like strawberry. I like what could with the strawberries. And I like just plain cheesecake. Put that in my mouth hole, please. The song in that bag? I have no idea. What's my address? Fuck you, sushi. That's my address. Someone gave me cheesecake, I'd marry them on the spot? Man, that's easy. Anybody want to get married to Taken Asian? I think they're taken, though. Frozen or New York cheesecake? New York, are you a Nico Pringles? How many times can you say oof in 5 seconds? I don't know, do I have to dab while I do it? Oof, 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 oof.
How many was that?
I don't know, I wouldn't count, I was too busy dabbing.
Oh. Shit. I wasn't either. I got my food though.
Nice.
Yeah.
Being lactose intolerant and all this talk of cheesecake. That sucks, man. I would just get a new whole body at that rate. Have a good birthday, it's alright. Yo, what'd you eat? What are you eating?
Chicken with a broccoli slaw.
Can you even have broccoli? That's really close to grain, dude.
I can have
both
broccoli.
Both come from the ground.
You're right. Pretty good, though.
Can you eat cheese?
Mm-hmm.
You can eat cheese?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. I'm in on keto, dude. I'm just gonna eat cheese.
Fucking do it, dude.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Can you eat bacon, though?
Yeah.
Can you eat pork chop sandwich?
Not the sandwich.
Damn it. I tried to sneak it in.
I know. Didn't work, though.
Fuck. What if I toast the bread first?
Does nothing. You just change the way it looks.
What if I take the yeast out and use pito?